on the science of longevity. Reaching the century mark sounds tantalizing, but is it possible for everyone? Here's NBC's chief medical editor, Dr. Nancy Snyderman.
Is all a gift.
That's true. So how did she do? Well, Dr. Tanya Benenson, an internist and chief.
Tanya,
so Tanya, you don't know what the results are, and so we're going to put them up on the monitor as you explain.
Average of your same age.
Which means that she's healthy.
I'm not stupid.
What you can do, ask for nutritional profile tests, take your medication.
This doesn't shock me.
No.
It's sobering to me.
It shocks me, though.
It's sobering to me, and I wish it weren't what it is. I say, tell myself to get my act together.
Okay, but does that mean, the question is for $290.
It's a special test.
And so the question is it worth it? And do you think it was worth it for you to,
right? We'll do that, Tanya.
Clean up my act, babe.
Back right
after. You can do it.
The defense is making a lot about this video that was shown with Casey's face sort of superimposed over this image of Kaylee's face and the skull and all of this. I mean, they're asking for a mistrial, saying that this photo is highly prejudicial. Could this actually lead to a mistrial?
Well, the judge has denied Kaylee's body was recovered. So
I'm sure we're paying a lot of attention to this very powerful testimony from the medical examiner. Mm-hmm. And she made this comment we just heard, talking about how she said that Kaylee's death was a homicide. Non-scientific testimony from a medical examiner in a case like this.
It was
of her daughter. And just emotional and having to leave the courtroom at one point. Is there a possibility that this could actually create some sympathy in the jury for a mother? Morning. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Always great to get your perspective. And now we want to get a check of the weather from Al, who's joining us now from Anchorage, Alaska. 23 years ago, Sue Meck's memory was erased after a ceiling fan fell on her head. Well, recently she achieved an amazing milestone, and she's not done yet. We're going to talk to both her.
So, first of all, with honors? Uh-huh. That's the way to roll.
Yes.
And your case, Jim, you're the only one who really remembers what happened 23 years ago. And so what I'm wondering is, what is it that doctors say actually happened when the ceiling fan hit your wife? Well, remarkably, your son Patrick, he was really unscathed. He was okay.
He was fine.
But in your case, I mean, you couldn't remember. So what was not remembering like?
I was more a big brother, and you don't kiss your big brother.
No. So it took a while. What do you think was the thing that really helped you in the end make peace with what had happened? So life goes on. And what would you say, above all, one learns from this kind of trauma, this kind of fear, this kind of...
No matter what.
And yourself.
Right.
And here you are emerging.
And it was very confusing to me because
and soon you'll be a Smith graduate.
Yes.
Sue, thanks so much.
Thanks.
You must
thanks
be so
much.
Proud. I'm so glad to meet both of you.
Thank
thanks,
you.
Jim. And we've got much more coming up in just a moment. But first, this is Today on NBC.
Back now at 8:11 with a story that's getting a lot of attention online. American Apparel held a search for a plus-size model, a contest that one Dallas woman found insulting. So Nancy Upton sent in some outrageous photographs to mock the competition, and to her surprise, she actually won the competition, and that didn't sit well with the company. So we'll talk to Nancy in just
a minute.
Why do you think?
I
changes minds, because after that scathing email, we now have an email because we reached out to American Apparel mm-hmm. from them, and it says XL model search that we could have done differently, and given the opportunity again, we likely would. That said, we are extremely excited about the amazing woman we have discovered through the contest and can't wait to work with them. So now you're heading to the headquarters in Los Angeles.
Yes.
Are you open-minded? I mean, what's your goal in talking to them?
No. And as far as heading out there, I'm really...
Your message then to American Apparel or any company that's trying to sort of market to plus-size women, what is the message? What is it you're trying to say? You're saying that some of the words they were using, obviously you're saying, we're marginalizing women who
Absolute.
Are plus-size.
Why would you be called beautiful and I would be called bootylicious? It's because I'm a little bit bigger than you.
Mm.
And it's like, why can't we both?
For him. I mean, I'm telling you, because you're coming with the complete package. You are beautiful, but you're also a strong message.
Thank you.
So you would, if you found the right one after that meeting, Nancy Upton.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Fun,
Thanks.
Fun meeting
Thank you,
you
for having me here.
And now, here's Matt. 6 million people in this country suffer from some form of anxiety disorder. New York Times bestselling author, both of you.
Good morning.
So here you are, a happily married woman. You've got two successful life, and yet you say you had this deep secret.
I did. I was reading about these monks who's meditation.
These ideas of panic attacks, this is not uncommon, is it?
It's not uncommon at all. And as you say, if we kind of relax our bodies and relax our minds.
I think we all can identify with the idea of having deep anxiety.
Yes.
But this idea of having panic attacks, there are some people who are more predisposed. I mean, I think that what we're really talking about is this being a fix or a help for people who really suffer deep, deep panic.
Yes, and they can
be in terms of some predisposition.
Absolutely.
Because of some inherited
Absolutely.
Items, or it could be because of some specific trauma. And you've talked about in your book about having had some trauma. But so here's the thing that people want to know. Okay, so now that we've disclosed the problem, what is the first step that makes you, in those moments of panic and fear, calm down?
Well, you know, fluorescent lights, she said, you know, if you're sitting there.
That's so useful, is that no matter what it is to do, is to have a deeper breath so that we can really focus on keeping ourselves grounded, as you said. And whether it's post-traumatic, we really can have compassion for ourselves.
Right. Deep breath, and all the details about this, I know,
yes.
are in our book, and your effort to help people and yourself. Priscilla Warner, thank you so much
thank
for being
you.
So generous.
I hope I help some people out
I'm
there.
I'm sure you will, and also
thank
Dale.
You.
Atkins.
Thank you
so much. And coming up next, what you can do this weekend to prepare for